A developer's editor is more than a tool. It's an extension of their mind. A perfectly tuned environment doesn't just make you faster, it removes friction, allowing you to stay in a state of creative flow. For the past few years, I've been refining my Neovim configuration into a system that is powerful, intelligent, and deeply personal. I've received a lot of questions about it. So today, we are doing the ultimate deep dive. We're not just scratching the surface. We are going file by file, line by line, through my entire Neovim setup for. We'll cover every option, every keymap, and every single plugin. This will be long, it will be detailed, so grab a coffee, and let's begin. Before we keep going, quick shout out to today's sponsor, TestSprite. If you've ever shipped a feature and thought, I hope nothing breaks, this one's for you. TestSprite is an AI-powered software testing agent that runs fully autonomous tests on your application. No test scripts. No manual QA. No babysitting. You describe what your app is supposed to do, and TestSprite handles the rest. What's wild is the speed. A full testing cycle takes 10 to 20 minutes, not hours or days. That means faster releases and way more confidence when you ship. And if you're using an AI-assisted IDE like Cursor, VS Code, Tray, or similar tools, this gets even better. TestSprite has an MCP Server integration, which means your IDE AI assistant can orchestrate the entire testing workflow directly from your editor. You write code, trigger tests, get results, without context switching. For solo devs, startups, and teams moving fast, this removes a huge bottleneck in the dev cycle. So instead of writing and maintaining test code, you can focus on building features that actually matter. If you want to check it out, head over to TestSprite using the link in the description. That link directly supports the channel and helps keep content like this coming. All right, back to the setup. The first thing you'll see is this ASCII art. It's a small personal touch, but it's the first thing I see when I open Neovim, and it makes the editor feel like my own. Everything starts here, in init.lua. Architecturally, this file is incredibly simple on purpose. Its only job is to bootstrap the three pillars of the configuration in a specific order. Require, config.options. This loads the fundamental, built-in behaviors of the editor. How it looks, feels, and acts before any plugins are involved. Require, config.keymaps. With the editor's behavior set, we then define our controls, the keyboard interface between us and the code. Require, config.lazy. And finally, with our foundation and controls in place, we load the arsenal, our entire suite of plugins using lazy Neovim. This separation of concerns is the most important principle of this setup. It makes it clean, modular, and easy to debug. Now, let's follow the chain and dive into options.lua. This file sets up Neovim's native behavior. Let's go through it. Vim.g.havenerdfont equals true. This is a global flag I set. It's not a Neovim option, but a variable I can check in other files to determine if it's safe to use special icons. You'll see this used by plugins like WitchKey and MiniStatusLine. Number and relative number. This enables hybrid line numbers. The current line shows its absolute number, while all other lines show their relative distance from the cursor. This is for efficient vertical movement. 10J jumps exactly 10 lines down. Mouse equals A enables the mouse in all modes. While I primarily use the keyboard, it's undeniably useful for quickly resizing splits or clicking on a far-off character. Show mode equals false. I disable this because my status line plugin, mini status line, already shows the current mode. This avoids redundant information. Clipboard equals unnamed plus absolutely essential. This makes Neovim's yank and paste operations use the system clipboard. I can copy a line here and paste it directly into a web browser. Break indent. This properly indents wrapped lines of text, making long, flowing paragraphs of text or code much more readable. Undo file enables persistent undo. Neovim saves undo history to a file, so I can close the editor, reopen a file hours later, and still undo changes. It's a safety net you'll be grateful for. Ignore case and smart case. This makes searching case insensitive by default, unless I use a capital letter in my search query. It's the best of both worlds. Sign column equals yes. This keeps the column on the left side of the editor, where diagnostic and git markers appear, always visible. This prevents the text from shifting annoyingly when a new marker is added. Update time and timeout len. These lower Neovim's default timers, making the editor feel more responsive, especially for plugins that react to you holding the cursor still or for leader key mappings. Split right and split below. These are my personal preferences for how new windows are created. New vertical splits will appear to the right, and horizontal splits to the bottom. Indentation I use for spaces for tabs, shift width, tab stop, soft tab stop, and expand tab to ensure the tab key always inserts spaces, which is a common convention. Smart indent and auto indent provide intelligent, context-aware indentation as I write new code. List and list chars, this visualizes white space. I can see trailing spaces as dots and tabs as arrows, which helps enforce clean code. Inc command equals split, a game changer for find and replace. It shows a live preview of your substitution command in a split window before you commit. Cursor line and scroll off equals 10. Cursor line highlights the current line I'm on, and scroll off keeps 10 lines of context visible above and below my cursor when I scroll. This helps me from ever feeling lost in a file. Confirm, if I try to quit with unsaved changes, Neovim will pop up a dialog asking if I want to save, instead of just yelling at me. Text length post auto command, finally, this little snippet makes the editor flash the region of text I just yanked. It's instant visual feedback that I copied exactly what I intended. With our options set, we define our controls. This file is highly opinionated. My leader key is space, the largest and most accessible key. It's the entry point for most of my custom shortcuts. Escape to disable search highlights, a simple quality of life map. When I search for something, the highlights are useful, but I want an easy way to clear them. Hitting escape in normal mode does that. Leaders queue, this opens the diagnostic quick fix list, showing all errors and warnings from my language server, which we'll cover later. Escape escaped in terminal mode, this lets me exit Neovim's built-in terminal and return to normal mode easily, without having to remember the awkward Control-Control-N default. Control plus HJKL, this is the standard, ergonomic way to navigate between window splits without ever leaving the home row. The arrow key philosophy, now for the most controversial part. This loop here completely disables the arrow keys in most modes. I do this to force the habit of using HJKL. It's painful for a week, and then it makes you permanently faster. However, I'm pragmatic. The second loop here remaps them to HJKL in insert mode and other modes when Alt is held down. This gives me precision cursor movement while typing, without having to leave insert mode. It's the perfect compromise between purism and practicality. Now for the main event. We will explore the lazy Envim config and then go through every single plugin file. Lazy Lua file bootstraps our plugin manager. It ensures lazy Envim is installed, then tells it to load every Lua file inside the Lua plugins directory. That's it. All the complexity is neatly encapsulated in the plugin files themselves. Let's go through them. AI.lua file or codeium. This is my primary AI auto-completion engine, providing ghost text suggestion similar to GitHub Copilot. I've set enable CMP source equals false because my main completion plugin, blink.cmp, will handle sourcing it. Autoindent.lua file or guess indent envim, a small but mighty utility that automatically detects the indentation style of a file when I open it. It saves me from having to manually set my tab width when switching between projects. Autopairs.lua file or mini.pairs, a lightweight plugin from the mini suite that automatically inserts closing brackets, parentheses, and quotes. A simple time saver. Avant Envim, this is a full-featured AI chat client inside Neovim. It's incredibly powerful. I've configured it with multiple providers like Claude and Moonshot, but my default is DeepSeek. It also uses ingclip Neovim to handle pasting images into a chat and render Markdown Neovim to display the AI responses beautifully. I can select a block of code and ask Avant to explain or refactor it. Blink Neovim, this is the brains of my auto-completion system. It's a modern, fast replacement for Neovim CMP. The preset equals default gives me same key maps, and the sources are configured to pull from my LSP, the file path, snippets, and lazy dev for when I'm editing my Neovim config itself. Conform.lua, this is my auto-formatting engine. It's set to run on buffer write. My leader F key map also triggers it manually. In the options, you can see I've configured it to use style Lua for formatting Lua files. FileManager.lua file or oil.nvim, this plugin replaces the default file browser in Neovim. I've mapped it to dash. It opens the parent directory in a buffer, allowing me to navigate and manipulate files and folders using standard Vim motions. Git signs, this provides all the Git integration in the editor's gutter. The on_attach function is key here. It maps a huge number of Git-related actions to keybinds under the leader h prefix for hunk. I can stage, reset, preview, and blame code blocks without ever leaving Neovim. Icons.lua file or mini.icons, another mini plugin that simply provides a library of icons that other plugins, like oil.nvim and witchkey, can use, provided my g.ofnerd font flag is true. Mini AI and mini surround, two more from the mini suite. Mini.ai provides more text objects for working with around and inside, and Mini Surround is a super fast way to add, delete, and change surrounding characters like quotes or brackets. Noise, this plugin is almost entirely responsible for the modern look and feel of my UI. It replaces the standard command line, messages, and pop-ups with a clean, unified, and extensible interface. Neovim LSP.lua, this is the massive configuration for the language server protocol. Dependencies, it pulls in mason.nvim to install and manage language servers, fidget.nvim to show LSP progress in the corner, and relies on blink.cmp. LSP attach, when an LSP connects to a buffer, this auto command runs, setting up all my LSP-specific key maps. This includes leader rn for rename, leader ca for code actions, and most importantly, it wires LSP actions like gd, go to definition, and gr, go to references, to use the snacks picker UI. Diagnostics, I've configured diagnostics to use nerd font icons for errors, warnings, info, and hints, and to display virtual text for clarity. Show keys, this is a meta plugin. It's what I'm using in this video to display my key presses on screen. Snacks Neovim, if lazy.neovim is the skeleton, Snacks Neovim is the central nervous system of my UI. Dashboard, this provides my startup screen, complete with my custom ASCII art header rendered via ASCII image converter. Functionality, it's a collection of modules. I use its picker for all fuzzy finding, replacing telescope. It has a LaserGit integration map to the leader LG, a terminal toggle on a control plus forward slash, and a massive suite of picker key maps under the leader S for finding files, grepping, searching key maps, diagnostics, and more. Statusline.lua file or mini statusline, a minimal and fast status line. I've configured it to use icons and customized the location section to be a clean lined column format. Theme.lua file or Tokyo Night Neovim, this sets the color scheme. It's set with priority equals 1000 to ensure it loads before other plugins and its colors are applied everywhere consistently. TreeSitter, this is Neovim's advanced parsing engine. It understands code structure far better than traditional regex-based highlighting. Ensure_installed, I have it set to install parsers for many languages for my work. Text objects, it also provides powerful text objects, allowing me to select, for example, the inside of a function with if or the outer class with ac. Witchkeys, the final piece of the puzzle for discoverability. When I press my leader key, space, and pause, a menu pops up showing me all possible key maps. I've configured it to group related commands, like leader C for code and leader S for search, making my complex configuration easy to navigate and learn. And that's it. Every line, every plugin, every choice explained. As you can see, this isn't just a random collection of tools, it's a cohesive, integrated system where each part is chosen to complement the others. My full .files, with all the code you saw today, are linked in the description. I encourage you to explore them. But don't just copy them. Fork them, question my choices, and adapt them to fit your workflow. That's the real power of Neovim. If you made it this far, thank you. I hope this deep dive was valuable. If it was, a subscription would be incredible. I have a lot more content like this planned. Stay sharp, and I'll see you in the next one.